I have conquered the need to conquer the world. This is a true quote from Arrian's Campaigns of Alexander, and a great story about Alexander that I want to concentrate entirely on this episode here. After Alexander had conquered the Persian Empire and had moved through the Afghan kingdoms, as we talked about a little earlier, he moved on to India, over the Hindu Kush into India. It's actually what today is Pakistan, but in Alexander's mind, in that era, it was India. And as they advanced into India, along the banks of the rivers, they encountered a type of person that they had never seen before. And these were yogis, sadhus, and the Macedonians called them gymnosophists. Gymnos in Greek means naked, and sophist means one who purveys wisdom. So gymnosophists was the naked wise men. And they were, in those days, just like they are today, if you go to India. They were renunciants, anchorites, who would often sit cross-legged in meditation all day long, trying to commune with the God within. And often they would own nothing except a loincloth and a begging bowl. And there's a story that Alexander was passing along one of the rivers one day with his retinue of officers, and he came to a spot in the sun where a bunch of these gymnosophists, the naked wise men, were sitting there in meditation, in contemplation. And as Alexander and his lieutenants came up to them, they tried to clear the road for Alexander to pass through. And most of the yogis cleared out except one guy who just sat there and remained there in meditation. So the lieutenant who was trying to clear him out, you know, was in a sort of a state of extremis here. And Alexander came up, and the wise man still wouldn't move. And the lieutenant, in outrage, turned, pointed to Alexander, and he said to the wise man, "This man has conquered the world. What have you done?" And the wise man, totally unperturbed and with the most kindness, he looked up and he said, "I have conquered the need to conquer the world." And at that, Alexander burst out laughing in approval. He thought that that was one of the funniest things and the best things he'd ever heard. And he later said, "If I could be anyone in the world other than myself, I would be this man right here." Now, to me, what's really interesting about this encounter, we talked earlier about when Alexander encountered the king Porus, P-O-R-U-S, and it was a clash of archetypes, the warrior archetype versus the king archetype. Now, in this case, with the wise man and with Alexander, we're talking about the warrior archetype and the sage archetype, the sage or the mystic. And clearly, the sage is the superior archetype here, is the one who is farther along on the evolutionary scale. And Alexander himself recognized it immediately when he laughed and when he approved of the wise man. And by the way, he didn't kick the wise man out of the way. He walked around him. So, which brings us now, this scene, I stole that scene and used it towards the end of my book, The Virtues of War. And which brings us now in our next episode, we're going to talk about the final scene in The Virtues of War, which involves my character who cannot die, Telamon of Arcadia, and how the naked wise men influenced him tremendously and started to move him beyond the warrior archetype.